Hello and welcome to my talk, Archaeology as a Foundation for Lore Building in the Myst video game series. My name is Dr. Brianna Jackson and I am currently visiting assistant professor at Pratt Institute in New York City. In 1993, independent computer game developer brothers Rand and Robin Miller, founders of Cyan Inc., released Myst, a first-person point-and-click adventure puzzle computer game. Its immediate success not only propelled CD-ROM format to be the standard for PC games, but also the Miller brothers were catapulted into popularity, even appearing in a Gap ad promoting excellent 1990s fashion. Myst soon became a franchise, culminating in 6 unique single-player games, multiple iterations of an online game, 3 novels, a few not exactly canon comic books, and various memorabilia, anniversary editions, and remasters, including the 2021 re-release of Myst in VR. In 2003, Cyan had high hopes for a massively multiplayer online, or MMO, game that takes place in an ancient city called Dunny that was left in ruins following a successful genocidal program implemented by 2 bitter, powerful rich men who fell from grace. The first iteration of the online game, first called Myst Online and then Uru Live, which was originally going to be the only version of it, was aimed at a larger audience that extended beyond Myst fans who had already devoured the rich lore presented in Myst, Riven, Myst 3 Exile, and 3 novels, which was a major part of what made Myst as a successful MMO challenging. How could Cyan build lore in one game for a new player that longtime fans had built over a period of 10 years? Cyan was possibly depending on partly upon players interacting with one another to discuss the lore, to help solve puzzles, and to encourage dialogue, but also the premise of the game is based upon a foundation of archaeological practices. Player enjoyment, investment, and interest in any game is dependent upon the degree to which the player is willing to learn these practices and dedicate time to note-taking. The publisher, Ubisoft, was not confident about the success of the MMO. This was a time before the Steam platform, before Discord, before the assistance of social media, and a time when people still used dial-up at home. Which meant you could not use internet and the telephone simultaneously. Uru Live was cancelled early, and the game was released instead as the single-player Uru Ages Beyond Myst, with the planned online content released as a single-player expansion packs in the following year. Cyan took control of the second online game attempt under the name Until Uru, until 2007, when the game was transferred to GameTap and released under the name Myst Online Uru Live, henceforth MUL, until 2008, when it was cancelled again. In 2010, Cyan made it open source and revived it under the name Myst Online Uru Live again, or MULA, and it is maintained by fans through Cyan's servers and is still playable today. The format of the Myst series is what I call a found experience. The player, referred to as the stranger in the single-player series, finds themselves in a situation with seemingly no context, and must thereby explore the environment and seek for information to slowly build an understanding and context of their situation. The player plays the game knowing it is solvable, but the immersive quality of the game that transforms the player into the stranger convinces the player that they have no choice but to proceed. In original Myst, this is cleverly achieved with the opening sequence that seems to start in the middle of the story. During a voiceover, a man falls into a fissure of stars, which presumably is a break in time and space. Then he touches a book and disappears, and the sequence ends with a single book landing on a surface within a solid black space. The book is titled Myst, and upon opening the book, a video panel embedded in the book page reveals a flyover of a strange-looking island. The player touches the panel and suddenly is transported to the island via the book that acts as a vehicle. The single player, Uru Ages Beyond Myst, or Complete Chronicles, after the inclusion of the expansion packs and henceforth Uru CC, and the MMO MUL, are presented in two different ways. The found experience in Uru CC begins in the desert of New Mexico and references the Starfisher of both Myst and Riven the game, with the ruins of Riven the place that had collapsed through the fissure at the end of Riven the game. This also in effect references the site of finding the Myst book in the game Myst. However, Mool begins in a different world called Relto that offers two choices on where to begin the game. In terms of lore, Uru CC makes more sense because the game begins where Myst began and where the main protagonist of the single-player series, Atris, began his story. In Mool, the player can choose to go first to this desert or go directly to the ancient ruined city Dunny. Mool is set up for new players to ask for help and direction. Linking to the city transports you to a neighborhood assigned to you and random other players, which connects you right away to other people. But if you're shy, there are signs that direct you to two areas that help you find where you should start your journey. Eventually, this path leads you to the desert where you can learn what your tasks are in the game, and that it centers around a character named Yisha, daughter of Atris. The player might ask the following questions. What is the point of the game? What is Dunny and why did it fall? Why am I in this city? Who is Yisha? What does she want? And why do I care? Myst fans who played Myst and Riven and read the three novels already enter the game knowing answers to some of these. Dunny is a 10,000-year-old city that is situated in a cavern deep below the New Mexico desert. The people are actually aliens, originally called Rone, who were from a planet called Gardernay. They escaped this planet because its sun was collapsing, and two groups of the Rone linked to two different worlds or ages via magical books written by specialist writers from the Guild of Writers. The Book of Earth was written by Rinaref, and he called their new home Dunny, meaning new beginning. The city fell in around 1744 of our current era after it was destroyed by Viovis, a promising master age writer and politician, the wealthy son of one of the rulers of Dunny, together with a disgraced former guildsman. Following a series of events that occurred after the first human, a geologist named Anna, later Tiana, found her way into the city and married Atris the Elder, a master of the Guild of Surveyors, and former best friend of Viovis. Following the fall, Anna brought her son Gen, later the villain in Riven, to live in a modest cavern on the surface referred to as the Cleft, and she raised her grandson Atris, the protagonist of the single-player Myst series. Uru CC and Mool pick up around 275 years after the fall of Dunny and about 200 years after the original game Myst. The found experience of the Uru and Mool games are twofold. The first is based on the story of Atris and his family presented by his daughter Yisha. The second is based on archaeologists encountering the ancient city Dunny and who began researching and restoring the city to prepare it for visitors. The two found experiences converge to create quite a complex story. The Yisha story presents the decadence of Dunny that contributed to its fall, whereas the archaeological story of the Dunny Restoration Council, or DRC, presents the glory of Dunny that they wanted to restore and preserve as a tourist site. In both cases, these stories told in Myst, Riven, and the novels, and the general more than 10,000 years of Dunny history needed to be told in Uru and Mool. The latter also pulled somewhat from Myst 5 End of Ages. As with other Myst games, lore building was accomplished through handwritten journals and puzzles. Usually, the journals written by in-game characters are directly relevant to solving the puzzles, but in Uru and Mool, the journals contain both personal accounts of day-to-day archaeological work in the city, as well as reports and research notes about Dunny culture and history. The archaeological practices that I noted in this game include, but are not limited to, excavation, conservation, restoration, cultural heritage preservation, site management, cultural and social anthropology, philology, GIS, geospatial analysis, and survey mapping. There's a great deal of material that goes beyond the scope of this paper, so I will stick to the very clever introduction to GIS and survey practices that help to tell the story of the founding of Dani and how building the city was accomplished 10,000 years ago and how certain guilds functioned. In Uru CC, the history of the founding of Dani is written as a report in a spiral-bound notebook that was left on a modern folding table set on the rooftop of a building in the city. It is the brief biography of the first king of Dani, Rinaref, who wrote the linking book to Earth and founded the new settlement of the Rone people. Like other notebooks and official reports found throughout the city, Rinaref's biography displays proof that it had been translated from the original Dani language by the philologists of the excavation team, and also considerable research in other primary sources was collected, which was cited in footnotes at the end of the report. In this way, the lore of the game is presented as academic research. The Rinaref notebook also helps to tie together the various integrations of GIS and survey methods introduced in the game. The founding of the city required the founding of the so-called Great Zero, which was the central coordinate established as the base point for the Dani coordinate reference system, which the player has the pleasure of calibrating. According to the report, when Rinaref completed writing the Book of Earth, he sent a team of surveyors from the Guild of Surveyors to establish the Great Zero and align it to magnetic north. It was along this line that the most important buildings were constructed, while the remainder of the city was constructed around it. With this information, the importance of the Guild of Surveyors is illuminated. One of their tasks was to perform land survey in new worlds prior to colonization and establish the base point for subsequent data collecting and mapping. This is similar to what occurs in archaeological missions, at one point even including the colonization part. In real archaeology, site surveys are carried out prior to digging, and sometimes even remote sensing is used as a site survey tool. At the start of excavation, grids are laid and survey data is continuously collected for the duration of the excavation to map layers, finds, and features for later georeferencing analysis. The Guild of Surveyors is further examined in-game in the age or world called Minketa, which is identified as a Guild of Surveyors training age. The notebook accompanying the Minketa linking book contains a series of compass roses together with Dani numbers. The numbers are already translated in the notebook and do not appear to require further understanding. However, numbers appear elsewhere in the game, requiring the player to learn numbers 1 through 6 for the first mission in Uru CC and Mool. The first encounter with Dani numerals occurs in Riven, presented in three number puzzles that serve as combination codes for locked machines. In a classroom on one of the Riven Islands, the player learns numbers 1 through 10 using a morbid child's toy that functions sort of as a game of hangman, and another sort of lesson in Dani numbers appears in the antagonist Gen's notebook containing combination codes to access to a special linking book. These numbers reach to 25. In all, these lessons teach the player that the Dani numerical system is base 25, and they must learn their numbers at least to 25 in order to access the book. Following through the lesson leads to the knowledge that the Dani number 100 is equivalent to our 625, a number that appears on the first page of the Minketa notebook as one of the number guides needed to understand the function of the age, which was training in orienteering. This is an exercise in navigation using a compass and a map, and in the case of this game, understanding that distance between two control points is measured in time. In Mool, numbers at least through 8 are found in the base game, but in the city, the so-called classroom in the neighborhood contains not only letters of the alphabet, also found in Riven, but also many numbers in sequence that should help to decode the Dunny numerical system. The numbers in the book correspond to Dunny time measurements, which are explained in a worksheet offered in the neighborhood classroom, indicating some math is required. However, another solution to this age is making use of vectors, adding the numbers between points and doing the math to map a direct path to the final point. In terms of GIS methodologies, the orienteering course probably aligns more closely in that the player must find the plotted points in the challenging terrain. Assistance is granted by the shadow of three suns and footprints left in the sand, but progress towards success is marked only by reaching the final destination. In terms of lore building, it is one of the few worlds that offers somewhat of an in-depth exploration into the functioning of a certain guild. The Guild of Surveyors is particularly of interest because it is the guild to which Atrus the Elder belonged, the hero of the novel The Book of Tiana, and the great-grandfather of the protagonist of the single-player Myst game series, Atrus the Younger. What else was intended for the world Minketa is unknown, since Mool was cancelled in 2008. In terms of MMO gameplay, the key device acquired in the base game in a world meant to train the Maintainers Guild, which was responsible for making sure ages were stable, was used for communication between players. However, it also had a lore aspect that was presented through archaeological practices and survey methods. As discussed above, the ruined city Dunny that at the time of the game was being excavated and restored was founded 10,000 years ago following the establishment of the Great Zero. This Great Zero is connected to a device referred to as a key, which is acquired by the player in another age and functions like a smartwatch. The purpose of the key differs somewhat between the offline Uru CC and online Mool games, and reasonably so. Mool's key system is primarily for communication, whereas in Uru CC it is directly tied to obtaining a single coordinate to access a location via a timed portal which is triggered upon calibrating the Great Zero. The functions and purposes of the key are detailed in notebooks found in three locations in the game. The most informative notebook is almost a manual for survey data collecting, and it is found in a closed-off antechamber to the Great Zero mechanism. In Uru CC, the Great Zero is not active. To proceed in the game and understand more of the narrative Yisha is trying to reveal to you, you are expected to turn on the machine and calibrate it by collecting markers in order to restore the sort of GPS built into the key device acquired earlier in the game. Mool's Great Zero is already operational, and the player needs only to calibrate their key, also by collecting markers, which would allow them to provide their exact location in the city to other explorers, as well as to set their own markers to create a game within the game. The markers are, from an archaeological survey perspective, data collection points that make up the coordinate reference system centered around the main reference point, which in the case of this game is the Great Zero. The player is essentially re-establishing the ancient demarcated line oriented to magnetic north that was introduced in one of the in-game archaeologist's research notes on the first king of Dunny, Rhenyrf. The player applies learned GIS skills that the Guild of Surveyors would also have used 10,000 years ago. The aim is to collect data points set at pre-established coordinates all around the Dunny city, sometimes requiring acrobatics to reach them, not unlike archaeological survey today. The player is learning the fictional ancient technique by using a modern one. Once fully calibrated in Mool, there is no further task, but in Uru CC, after completing the calibration and two other missions, the player must locate a specific coordinate and jump through the portal that opens there when the now operational Great Zero neutrino beam passes over that coordinate. The player is taken to the Great Shaft, which is an exciting location for the longtime Myst fan, as it is the remnant of the massive undertaking of the Dunny to reach the surface, and which ultimately led to Anna finding the Dani, which was the beginning of the collapse of the Dani civilization and the ensuing Myst series. More directly important to the Urusisi game, it is also the location of a journal of the sort of director of the archaeological mission. In it, the player learns that the director quit the mission and instead followed Yisha's journey, which he would not successfully accomplish without archaeological training. The found experience term that I discussed at the opening of this paper may also be applied to archaeology itself. In this respect, it is not surprising for archaeological practices to be a key component in learning the lore behind all the puzzles of the Myst games. My examination here is only scratching the surface of the topic of archaeological practices portrayed in Myst games, and I hope to continue this work further. And so I close, realizing that perhaps the ending has not yet been written.